we rock it, so don't stop. And under the lights when everything goes, nowhere to hide when I'm getting you close. When we move, well, you already know.
Let's go, let's walk.
So just imagine,
just imagine.
Just dance, dance, dance.
So just dance, dance, dance.
So keep.
Thank you. a real good hand. I'm glad to be here this morning to share a few thoughts with you as a parent and a grandparent. This school, known as the Sacred Heart Girls School, has a long history and has developed, if I may say so, into an empire. They are all over the country with a mission and with a vision. And they have helped to educate thousands of girls over all these decades. And their motto, whatever you do, do it well, is, I think, a very inspiring and important message for our young women. There are times when one looks at an institution and thinks of its glorious past. I want to say to you, parents, you have to be proud of the fact that your children are being educated in this institution. One of the few and one of the rare institutions of its kind in the country. You know, the state of education in our country is 70 years after freedom. Thousands of young girls are not in schools, or in schools which have much more to achieve in the name of education. You know what I mean. But your children are being educated in this atmosphere where each one of them is expected to develop the best and become truly worthy citizens of this country. I have to be very frank here this morning. Most parents believe that once their children are admitted into a school like this, to do the rest. How wrong this concept is. You cannot outsource parenthood. Your teachers can do their best. The institution, as you saw from the report, is providing all the facilities, the staff, and the support systems. But ultimately, I would say to you, it is our parents' responsibility to give to our children what they need. I know we are all working women these days. Mothers are busy, fathers have their careers, and we tend to leave our children more and more on their own. But it's not just the equipment and the facilities. It is what we as parents give of ourselves to our children. My daughter-in-law is a therapist for children physically fit, mentally alert, and spiritually alive. Religion is not a dead chapter, but religion has to create in us that feeling of love, of giving, of service, of acceptance, and of belonging to humanity. I thank you for this opportunity to be here. I may have sounded like a headmistress talking to the school children, but I'm talking from experience. I have worked for long years in the education field. I have traveled the length and breadth of this country and been at international conferences. Everyone talks of education as it is a great science. Education is basically about giving to the young systems, values, and love. If that we can do, I think we have played our role as parents, as teachers, and as makers of a new India. Thank you. God bless you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give her a huge round of applause. Ladies and gentlemen, a gentle reminder, please note your children will not be allowed to leave before the celebration ends, so please remain seated in the auditorium. Thank you.
Come on. Beloved principal, Sister Margaret, who has been the inspiration and guided force behind today's program. Thank you, Sister, for your encouragement, support, and above all, your prayers.